It was a February night in 1862 when the Victorian poet and painter Dante Gabriel Rossetti found his wife, Elizabeth Siddal, unconscious on her bed. He hastily opened a little note, an eloquent witness of probable suicide by laudanum overdose. Lizzie, a muse and a Pre-Raphaelite model, imbued with the fire of poetry and art as well, was in very fluctuating health after the tragic birth of their stillborn daughter. And during those feverish after-midnight hours, there was no sublime words on Rossetti's lips, but just the same fear that this red-gold-haired beauty and notorious model had lost her soul first in the freezing waters of their marriage. It was a short union, but Lizzie had the premonition many times before this fatal night, saying that Rossetti did not love her enough to save her from herself. As a 19th century writer put it, his love was sincere in its insincerity. At 7:20 a.m., Lizzie left this earth. Rossetti, desperate and shattered with guilt, decided to bury in Lizzie's coffin his manuscript of poems as a grave sacrifice, but it was a sacrifice with an expiry date. 6 years later, Rossetti decided to exhume his wife's remains and to publish the buried poems. Lizzie had been twice buried at Highgate indeed, but she was not gone. Her death brought her husband not only to self-isolation, but also to the world of paranormal. According to a biographer, for the next 2 years, Rossetti saw her nightly at the foot of his bed. Modern parapsychologists analyze that most apparitions are seen when the percipient is in bed, and they can be not only visual, but audible as well. Physical medium Alexander Stewart explained for Leslie Keene's Surviving Death book that the spirit people need to slow down their vibration in order to manifest themselves, describing this process to Keene as similar to walking through thick mud, or like wearing a heavy, wet overcoat. Rossetti's psi experiences, not only a result of his mental breakdown at the time, prompted him to devote the next 6 years of his life to mediumistic sessions at his Tudor house. He also attended psychic mediumship demonstrations staged by the most sought-after mediums of his time, Davenport brothers. The brothers, Ira Erostras and William Henry, had given seances even in the Winter Palace to the Russian Tsar and imperial family. More than a decade later, in April 1882, Rossetti's brother William was shocked to find Gabriel in a very prostrate condition physically, barely capable of tottering a few steps, half blind, and suffering a good deal of pain. Rossetti was addicted to chloral and alcohol, and it was the point of no return for him. On Easter Sunday, April 9th, 1882, William was also stunned to hear Gabriel's prophetic prediction of his own death. "I believe I shall die tonight," he had said, and later, haunted by the memory of his twice-buried wife, "as white as snow," he expressed his deathbed will again. "Let me not, on any account, be buried at Highgate." That was all that a man wrapped in hot sheets with mustard poultice, prescribed by a doctor, could have prayed for at a seaside bungalow. And then, at 9:20 p.m., he was carried off by the red-gold waters of the River of Death.